So the basic structure of today's lecture will be discussing the methods of price level accounting, what kind of methods we follow to record the various transaction and to update the various financial items of the financial statements as per the requirements of the price level changes. So that will be the basic topic that we'll be discussing today. So let's move to the presentation straight away. So methods of price level changes that we are going to discuss today. Basically there are two methods which we follow generally for accounting for price level changes. One is current purchasing power method. And this method is also called general purchasing power method. Under this method, we update the value of the various financial items in the financial statements as per the price level index. And second method is current cost accounting method. So under this method, we update the values of as per the replacement cost of the asset. So first we will be discussing the method that is called current purchasing power method. And this method has been developed by the Institute of Chartered Accountants in England and Wales and recommended that the changes in the price level should be reflected in the financial statements through the current purchasing power of the various financial various organizations. And for measuring the changes in the price level and incorporating the changes in the financial statement, we use index numbers, which may be considered to be barometer meant for the purpose. So under this method, the financial items, the items of the financial statements are restated with the help of the index number, which may be considered to be the barometer for this purpose. For example, when the particular asset was purchased, what was the index at that time, price index at that time? And presently, when we are going to convert this item, what is the price index at present time? So taking into account, we will calculate a conversion index, and accordingly we will convert all the figures of the financial statements as per the conversion factor. All financial statement items are restated. So under this method, any established and approved general price index may be used to convert the values of the various items in the balance sheet and profit and loss account. And this method takes into account the changes in the value of the item as a result of general price level, but it does not take into account for changes in the value of individual item. Sometimes some assets may be there whose value has been down as compared to the price level changes, but this method will not take into account because individual changes in the value of the item will not be considered, only the general price level. If there is a rise in the general price level, we will inflate the value of that particular asset or liability. If there is a downfall in the general price level, we will decrease the value of the asset or liability in the financial statement. So current purchasing power method take into account the index number, which may be considered as a barometer for the purpose of conversion. So on the basis of this, we will calculate the conversion factor. For example, this method will not take into account the individual value of the assets. For example, a particular machine may have become cheaper over the last few years, whereas the general price level may have risen. The value of machine will be raised in accordance with the general price index. So thus, general price level adjustment restate financial data by bringing past rupee amounts in line to the current rupee purchasing power by general index multiplier. So here we will take the general index multiplier, and on the basis of that, all the items of the financial statements will be restated as per the accounting for price level requirements. For example, first step we will follow, we will calculate the conversion factor. The preparation of the financial statement according to current purchasing power method needs to understand first of all the current factor. Conversion factor. Conversion factor under current purchasing power method involves the restatement of historical figures at the current purchasing power. And for this purpose, historical figures must be multiplied by conversion factor, and the formula is price index at the date of revaluation. For example, we are calculating the value of the asset in 2020. So price index on the date of revaluation we will take, and it will be divided by price index at the date of existing figure. That means when the asset must have been purchased. So in this way, we will calculate the conversion factor. For example, presently we may have the price index 220, but at the time when the asset was purchased, at that time index figures may be 150. So conversion factor will be 220 divided by 150. So this conversion factor will be multiplied with all the figures in the financial statements, and accordingly the values will be restated. For example, a company purchased a machine on 1st January 2004 for 60,000, and the retail price index on that date was 150. So this is a general price index at the time of purchase. Now you are required to restate the value of the machine according to CPP method, that is current purchasing power method, on 31st December 2004, when the price index stood at 200. So conversion factor will be price index at the date of revaluation, that is 31st 2004, that is 200. And at the time when it was purchased, that was 1st 1 2004, that was 150. So 4/3 will be the conversion factor. So machine di agar assi value calculate karni hai, current value calculate karni hai, ta 60,000 nu assi 4/3 naal multiply kar denge, and then we will get the restated value of 80,000. So immediately, if you want to find out the directly the increase in the existing value as compared to the others, but then difference can be calculated, that is existing value multiplied by brackets conversion factor, that is 4/3 we have calculated, minus 1. So straight away 2000 difference in the price you will be able to find out. So earlier price was 60,000 plus 20,000, so new value will be 80,000. So in this way we will find out the conversion factor, and assets and liabilities will be multiplied with the conversion factor to restate the values of assets and liabilities that is presented in the financial statement, that is balance sheet. Same methodology is adopted for profit and loss account. So sometime we use the conversion factor at the date of revaluation divided by the index price at the time of purchase, but sometime mid conversion period may be used. So in case of transaction that are occurring throughout the period, it will be advisable to convert them according to average index of the period. So such transactions generally include revenue items such as sales and purchase of goods, payment of expenses. In case the information regarding average index is not available, it may be calculated by taking the average index of the at the beginning and at the end of the period. So sometime, for example, you have to calculate the average index. In the beginning of the year, average index was 150. So at the end of the year, the index was 200. So we will take average 150 plus 200 divided by 2. So this will become the index for the mid conversion period. So accordingly, date of revaluation, on the date of revaluation, we will find the index divided by this mid conversion period index, and we will be able to find out the conversion period, conversion factor. So there are two types of items in the financial statements which are converted. One is monetary item and another are non-monetary item. What are the monetary items? Monetary items are those which are realizable in 1 year. For example, assets and liability, the amount of which are fixed by the contract or otherwise and expressed in terms of money, regardless of changes in the general price level. For example, your cash is there, your bank balance is there, bill receivable is there, bills payable is there, debtors are there, creditors are there, outstanding expenses are there, prepaid expenses are there. They represent specific monetary claim which is receivable or payable in specified number of rupees regardless of the price level changes. So these are the contract items. For example, debtors are not going to pay you more in case the price level index increases. Similarly, you are not going to pay to the creditors more even if the price level index changes. For example, a person lent to a company a sum of 10,000 on 1st January 2004 and which is payable on 31st December 2004. The price index on 1st January 2004 was 100, while it is 150 on 31st December 2004. So if this creditor is compensated for loss in purchasing power on the amount of increase in the price level, he should have been paid 15,000, because conversion factor will become 150 over 100 and it will be multiplied by with the 10,000. However, he will be paid only contract amount 10,000. So in case of monetary item, there's no need to convert them. So if there is a profit or loss is there, that is not accounted as per the concept of conservatism we follow in while preparing our financial statement. So in case of monetary item like cash, bank, bill receivable, bills payable, debtors, creditor, outstanding expenses, prepaid expenses, these represent specific monetary claim, and regardless of the price level changes, we will pay the same amount. We will not change it. Second, similarly, the company here, if you find out, otherwise your amount is payable, that is 10,000, but creditor has in a loss of 5,000. Similarly, the company is gaining 5,000 while the lender is losing 5,000. So monetary items need not conversion, since they are already stated in the current rupees at the end of the period to which the account restated. Now we must come to the non-monetary item. Contrary to the monetary item, non-monetary item denotes, for example, assets are there, fixed assets are there, fixed liabilities are there. They do not represent specific monetary claim, include land, building, machinery, investment, stock. For example, land costing 50,000 in 1988 may be sold for 1 lakh in 2000. So that this is due to the change in the general price level. So non-monetary items do not carry a fixed value like monetary items. So therefore, under current purchasing power method, all such items are to be restated to represent the current general. So one thing should be kept in mind that as far as the monetary items are concerned, they need not to be converted because they represent the current value. You are not going to pay more or less as stated in the contract. But as far as the non-monetary items are concerned, such as assets, liabilities, they do not represent any specific monetary claims. So therefore, they need to be restated with the use of a current factor, a conversion factor, which we will calculate. Already we have discussed this point. So monetary assets lose their value during the period of inflation since they are expressed in fixed monetary value. Similarly, there is a gain in holding monetary liabilities because you are not going to pay more. You will be paying, if creditor owe rupees 10,000 from you, you will be paying rupees 10,000. Even then its value has become 15,000. So according the loss by holding monetary asset is offset to a title extent by gain or monetary liability. So difference between loss and gain indicate the extent to which concern is exposed to inflation, but that is not accounted for in the statement of balance sheet or in the profit and loss account. So here is one example. So that I will forward you. You may just hear the conversion factors are given. So accordingly, you can calculate the values. For example, in case of cash, there is no need to calculate. So if the cash opening is there, 5,000 and closing 10,000 is there, you are not going to calculate it. Similarly, this example I will be sending you. So you will be calculating their conversion factor, which in the working notes it has been given to you. So accordingly, you will find out the net gains on monetary or non-monetary items as per the requirement. Similarly, the cost of sales and inventories. Cost of sales or inventory value vary according to the cross flow assumption. We may have used FIFO method or LIFO method. So under FIFO method, cost of sale comprise the entire opening stock and current purchases minus closing stock, and the closing stock is entirely from the current purchases. So there is no need to value calculate. But under the LIFO method of costs of sale comprise current purchases only. However, if the current purchases are less than the cost of sale, a part of opening inventory may also become a part of the cost of sale. So accordingly, closing stock comprises purchases made in the previous year, so that need to be converted. So the following indexes are used under current purchasing method for restating the historical values. For example, for current purchases, we will be using average index of the year. For opening stock, index at the beginning of the year will be used. And for purchases of the previous year, average index of the previous year will be used. So when you calculate the current conversion factor, you must take into account that for current purchases, average index should be taken into account. For opening stock, index at the beginning of the year should be taken account, and for purchases of the previous year, average index of the last year will be taken into account. For example, this has been given the following data: calculate cost of sales and cost of inventory under CPP method, presuming that the firm is following last in first out. So inventory in the beginning is given, historical cost purchases is given. Similarly, closing stock is given for opening from opening inventory, 8,000 from closing inventory, 4,000 cost of goods is calculated. Here the conversion factor are given to you. So average conversion factor is 140, and at the time of purchase of these assets, different indexes are given and these conversion factors are calculated. So in this way, the cost of goods sold, earlier it was 44,000, now it has become 49,280. So this has been restated. So in this way, we will restate the values of the profit and loss account and balance sheet and find out the revised financial statements. Similarly, for the determination of profit, under current purchasing power method, the profit can be determined in two ways. Number one is net change method. So this method is based on normal accounting principle that profit is the change in equity during the accounting period. So we will find out the opening equity, we will find out the closing equity, and the difference will be treated as profit. So in order to determine this change, the following steps are taken. First, opening balance sheet prepared under historical cost accounting method is converted into CPP terms at the end of the year. So you have a balance sheet which is prepared on historical cost basis. You will convert it into the by taking into account the conversion factor, and we will calculate the various figures of this balance sheet at the end of the year with conversion factor. So this is done by application of proper conversion factor to both monetary as well as non-monetary item. Equity share capital is also converted. So the difference bit of the balance sheet is taken as reserve. Alternatively, the equity share capital may not be converted and the difference in the balance sheet is taken as equity. So choice is used. So closing balance sheet prepared under the historical is also converted. The difference between the two sides of the balance sheet is put as reserve after converting the equity capital. So alternatively, the equity capital may not be restated in CPP terms and balance as taken as equity. So profit is equivalent to net change in the equity. So equity as per the converted balance sheet in the opening and equity as per the converted balance sheet at the end of the year, the difference will be treated as reserve, which is the amount of the profit. So conversion or restatement of income statement method is also there. So in case of this method, the income statement prepared on historical cost basis is restated in CPP term generally on this basis. So sales and operating expenses are converted at the average rate applicable for the year. Cost of sale is calculated, as we have already discussed, that FIFO or LIFO method as explained in the preceding pages. So fixed assets are converted on the basis of indices prevailing on the dates when they were purchased, and same applied to depreciation. Taxes and dividends are converted on the basis of indices that were prevalent on the dates they were paid. Gain or loss on account of monetary items should also be calculated and stated separately in the restated income statement to arrive at the overall figure of the profit or loss. This was the first method in which we take into account only the conversion factor at the various points of time to convert the various figures of the financial statement, that is profit and loss account and balance sheet. Second method is current cost accounting method. So this current cost accounting method is an alternative to the current purchasing power method in which we use the conversion factor taking into account the general price level at the time of revaluation and at the time of purchase or mid period or average index. So price changes may be general or specific. So changes in general level of price which occur as a result of a change in monetary value of the monetary units are measured by index number as we have seen in the last method. So specific price changes occur if the price of a particular asset held change without any general price movement. Sometimes it happens because in the last method, we do not take into account the individual increase in the prices or decrease in the prices of a particular asset. So under this method, assets are valued at current cost. So for each and every asset, current cost of asset is found out. So current cost is the cost at which asset can be replaced as on a date. So while the current purchasing power method is known as general price level approach, so here we will not follow general price level approach. We will find out the current cost of each asset and liability. So while current purchasing power method is known as general price level approach and the current cost method is known as specific price level approach for replacement cost accounting. So this method has been suggested by Sandilands Committee of UK. The Sandilands Committee published its report in September 1975 recommending the adoption of current cost accounting for dealing with the problems in the inflation accounting. So in this method, historical values of the items are not taken into account, rather their current values of the individual items are taken on the basis of preparing the profit and loss account and balance sheet. So thus, items are not adjusted as a result of change in the general price level, but they are adjusted in the current as they are adjusted in the CPP. So we will find out the revalued or the current value of each and every item. So I have already told you, because presently we don't have the concept of price level accounting. We have the concept of new concept of fair value accounting, under which the methodology is prescribed how to restate the values of the assets and liabilities. If there is any profit or loss because of the adjustment in the values of asset, that they are transferred to the revaluation reserves and shown in the balance sheet. So presently these two methods are not adopted, but the fair value accounting is adopted. So for this, therefore, for this purpose, you need to study these concepts only theoretically. There will be no practical question on this. So you just remember that there are two methods. One is CPP method and second is CCA method. So under CPP method, we adjust or restate the values of the assets and liabilities, monetary and non-monetary items as per the conversion factor. And in current cost accounting, we adjust the values of the various assets and liabilities in the balance sheet or in the profit and loss account as per the present value, or you can find out the as a value of current value of individual items are taken into consideration, not any price level index. So this was all about the various methods which are we prepare. So there are certain features of current cost accounting method. Number one, fixed asset to be shown in the balance sheet in their value to the business and not historical cost as reduced by depreciation. So this is assets are shown in terms of which assets would be available at the current cost in the market. So similarly, inventories are shown in the balance sheet at their value prevailing to the date of balance sheet. So whatever stock of inventory is lying, we will find out the current value in the market, and according to that we will inflate the value. So these are not at shown at cost or market price, whichever is there. So in case of historical accounting, so depreciation is to be computed on the current value of the fixed asset. The cost of goods sold during the year has to be ascertained on the basis of the prices prevailing at the date of consumption and not at the date of purchase. Similarly, the difference between the current values and the depreciated original cost of the fixed assets and stocks, the increased requirements for monetary working capital and under provision of depreciation in the past year may be adjusted through revaluation reserve account. So whatever the difference in the prices, because of the difference in the prices is there, we will prepare a revaluation reserve account and all the entries will be adjusted to the accordingly. So the fixed assets are shown at their value to the business, and the value to the business can be defined in the three ways. Number one, replacement cost is the estimated cost of acquiring the new asset of the same productive quantity at current prices adjusted for estimated depreciation. For example, your asset is 5 year old. So you will find the current value of the asset like what is the purchase price of that asset now minus depreciation of the last 5 years. So that will give you the current value. Similarly, net realizable value is the estimated selling price in the ordinary course of business, the value at which the asset can be sold in the market, that is predictable cost of completion or disposable. So third value is economic value, is the sum of discounted future cash flows expected from the use of the asset during the useful life. So thin method is used kar sakte hain. Pehli cheez replacement, kinne te assi nama asset khareed sakde hain. Je nama asset hai, aaj 50,000 da hai, lekin sada asset 5 saal purana hai. So 5 year the depreciation as less karke current value de vich ohdi replacement cost find out kar lange. Similarly, jehdi net realizable value is the estimated selling price ki ajj assi us asset nu kinne da vech sakde ha, ohdi jehdi net realizable value kinni hai. Teesra ki aun wale saalan de vich ohde to ki future cash flows hona, oh sara assi calculate karke ohdi ajj di present value find out kar lange. So we will get the value of the assets. So isi tarah current cost, operating profit, we will make certain adjustment to trading account which are calculated on the basis of historical cost before interest are required to arrive at current operating cost. So these are called depreciation adjustment. Depreciation adjustment mean kyunki hun asset di value si badhati, so depreciation bhi navi value te lagegi. Cost of sale adjustment kyunki jehde sadi inventory hai ਜਿਹੜੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਬਾਏ ਕੀਤੀ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਅੱਜ ਦੀ ਵੈਲਿਊ ਉਹਦੇ ਚ ਸਟਾਕ ਦੀ ਕਿੰਨੀ ਪਈ ਹੈ ਕਲੋਜ਼ਿੰਗ ਸਟਾਕ ਦੀ ਉਹਦੇ ਬੇਸਿਸ ਤੇ ਕੈਲਕੂਲੇਟ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ। ਸੋ ਇਸੇ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਜਿਹੜੀਆਂ ਕੈਸ਼ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਜਾਂ ਦੂਸਰੀਆਂ ਆਈਟਮਸ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਐਡਜਸਟਮੈਂਟ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ। ਮੇਨ ਇਹਦੇ ਤੇ ਡੈਪਰੀਸੀਏਸ਼ਨ ਦੀ ਐਡਜਸਟਮੈਂਟ ਆਏਗੀ। ਸੋ ਇਸੇ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਕੋਸਟ ਆਫ ਸੇਲ ਐਡਜਸਟਮੈਂਟ, ਸੋ ਇਹਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਰੰਟ ਕੋਸਟ ਮਸਟ ਬੀ ਮੈਚ ਵਿਦ ਦਾ ਕਰੰਟ ਰੈਵਨਿਊ। ਸੋ ਜਿੰਨੀਆਂ ਆਈਟਮ ਸਾਡੀਆਂ ਪ੍ਰੋਫਿਟ ਐਂਡ ਲਾਸ ਅਕਾਊਂਟ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਦਿੱਤੀਆਂ ਹੋਈਆਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਸਾਰੀਆਂ ਆਈਟਮਸ ਦੀ ਕਰੰਟ ਕੋਸਟ ਕੱਢ ਲਵਾਂਗੇ ਤੇ ਰੈਵਨਿਊਜ਼ ਦੀ ਵੀ ਕਰੰਟ ਕੋਸਟ ਕੱਢ ਲਵਾਂਗੇ। ਸੋ ਮੋਸਟਲੀ ਜਿਹੜੀਆਂ ਮੋਨਿਟਰੀ ਆਈਟਮਸ ਹੁੰਦੀਆਂ ਉਹਦੀ ਕਰੰਟ ਕੋਸਟ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਉਹੀ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਹੈ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਆਪਾਂ ਬਾਏ ਕੀਤੀ ਹੁੰਦੀ। ਸੋ ਵਨ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਫੀਚਰ ਆਫ ਕਰੰਟ ਕੋਸਟ ਅਕਾਊਂਟਿੰਗ ਇਜ਼ ਟੂ ਸ਼ੋਅ ਇਨਵੈਂਟਰੀਜ਼ ਐਟ ਦ ਬੈਲੈਂਸ ਸ਼ੀਟ ਔਨ ਦੀ ਬੇਸਿਸ ਆਫ ਦੇਅਰ ਵੈਲਿਊ ਟੂ ਦਾ ਬਿਜ਼ਨਸ ਐਂਡ ਨਾਟ ਔਨ ਦੀ ਕੋਸਟ ਔਰ ਮਾਰਕੀਟ ਪ੍ਰਾਈਸ ਵਿਚ ਐਵਰ ਲਈਏ। ਅਸੀਂ ਆਮ ਤੌਰ ਤੇ ਕੋਸਟ ਔਰ ਮਾਰਕੀਟ ਪ੍ਰਾਈਸ ਵਿਚ ਐਵਰ ਇਜ਼ ਲੋਅਰ ਦਾ ਕਨਸੈਪਟ ਹਿਸਟੋਰੀਕਲ ਕੋਸਟ ਅਕਾਊਂਟਿੰਗ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਫੋਲੋ ਕਰਦੇ ਸੀ, ਲੇਕਿਨ ਕਰੰਟ ਕੋਸਟ ਅਕਾਊਂਟਿੰਗ ਦੇ ਮੈਥਡ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਸੀਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਫੋਲੋ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ। ਇਫ ਦੇਰ ਆਰ ਸਟਾਕ ਸਰਟਨ ਐਡਜਸਟਮੈਂਟ ਵਿਲ ਬੀ ਮੇਡ ਟੂ ਦੀ ਕੋਸਟ ਆਫ ਸੇਲ, ਇਫ ਦੇਰ ਆਰ ਨੋ ਸਟਾਕ ਦਾ ਕੋਸਟ ਆਫ ਸੇਲ ਵਿਲ ਕੰਪਰਾਈਜ਼ ਓਨਲੀ ਕਰੰਟ ਪਰਚੇਜ਼ ਐਂਡ ਦਾ ਕਰੰਟ, ਫਿਰ ਕੋਈ ਐਡਜਸਟਮੈਂਟ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਲੋੜ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈ। ਸੋ ਦੋ ਮੈਥਡ ਸਾਡੇ ਕੋਲ ਅਵੇਲੇਬਲ ਨੇ, ਇੱਕ ਸੀ ਪੀ ਪੀ ਮੈਥਡ ਹੈ, ਇੱਕ ਸੀ ਸੀ ਏ ਮੈਥਡ ਹੈ। ਸੋ ਇਹ ਪ੍ਰੈਜੈਂਟੇਸ਼ਨ ਮੈਂ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਭੇਜ ਵੀ ਦਿਆਂਗਾ, ਦ ਮੋਰ ਯੂ ਰੀਡ ਦ ਮੋਰ ਯੂ ਵਿਲ ਗੈਟ ਦ ਕਲੈਰੀਫਿਕੇਸ਼ਨ। ਸੋ ਉਹ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਬੈਨੀਫਿਸ਼ੀਅਲ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਉਹ ਤਾਂ ਹੀ ਹੋਏਗਾ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਇਹਦੇ ਚੋਂ ਥਰੈਟੀਕਲ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਆਉਣਾ। ਸੋ ਅਕੋਰਡਿੰਗਲੀ ਵੀ ਵਿਲ ਪ੍ਰਿਪੇਅਰ ਦਾ ਥਰੈਟੀਕਲ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ। ਸੋ ਇਹਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਸਾਡੀਆਂ ਜਿਹੜੀਆਂ ਕੰਟੈਂਪਰੇਰੀ ਇਸ਼ੂਜ਼ ਇਨ ਅਕਾਊਂਟਿੰਗ ਹੈ, ਜਿਹਦੇ 'ਚ ਅਸੀਂ ਹਿਊਮਨ ਰਿਸੋਰਸ ਅਕਾਊਂਟਿੰਗ ਡਿਸਕਸ ਕੀਤਾ, ਸੋਸ਼ਲ ਅਕਾਊਂਟਿੰਗ ਡਿਸਕਸ ਕੀਤਾ, ਪ੍ਰਾਈਸ ਲੈਵਲ ਅਕਾਊਂਟਿੰਗ ਡਿਸਕਸ ਕੀਤਾ, ਇਨਵਾਇਰਮੈਂਟਲ ਅਕਾਊਂਟਿੰਗ ਡਿਸਕਸ ਕੀਤਾ, ਉਹ ਸਾਰੇ ਖਤਮ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਆ। ਹੁਣ ਸਾਡੇ ਕੋਲ ਪੋਰਸ਼ਨ ਸਿਰਫ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਉਹ ਰਹਿ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਕੋਸਟ ਅਕਾਊਂਟਿੰਗ ਵਾਲਾ, ਜਿਹਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਸੀਂ ਹਾਊ ਟੂ ਅਰਾਈਵ ਐਟ ਦੀ ਕੋਸਟ ਆਫ ਪ੍ਰੋਡਕਸ਼ਨ ਉਹ ਡਿਸਕਸ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ, ਤੇ ਨਾਲ ਦੀ ਨਾਲ ਸੈਕੰਡਲੀ ਵੀ ਵਿਲ ਡਿਸਕਸ ਮਾਰਜਨਲ ਕੋਸਟਿੰਗ ਦਾ ਕਨਸੈਪਟ, ਸਟੈਂਡਰਡ ਕੋਸਟਿੰਗ ਦਾ ਕਨਸੈਪਟ, ਬਜਟਰੀ ਕੰਟਰੋਲ ਦਾ ਕਨਸੈਪਟ। ਇਹ ਤਿੰਨ ਚਾਰ ਕਨਸੈਪਟ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਹੈ ਦੈਟ ਵੀ ਵਿਲ ਬੀ ਡਿਸਕਸਿੰਗ ਇਨ ਦਾ ਫਿਊਚਰ ਲੈਕਚਰ, ਠੀਕ ਹੈ ਜੀ। ਸੋ ਓਕੇ, ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਵੈਰੀ ਮੱਚ, ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਅਨਫ ਫੋਰ ਟੂਡੇ। ਸੋ ਇਹ ਪ੍ਰੈਜੈਂਟੇਸ਼ਨ ਮੈਂ ਅੱਜ ਹੀ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਪਾ ਦੂੰਗਾ ਉਹਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ, ਸੋ ਯੂ ਰੀਡ ਦਿਸ ਪ੍ਰੈਜੈਂਟੇਸ਼ਨ। ਸੋ ਇਹਦੇ 'ਚ ਜੇ ਕੋਈ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਕੋਈ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਲੱਗੇ ਤਾਂ ਦੈਨ ਯੂ ਕੈਨ ਆਸਕ ਮੀ, ਬਟ ਥਰੈਟੀਕਲੀ ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਟੂ ਪ੍ਰਿਪੇਅਰ, ਨੋ ਨੀਡ ਟੂ ਪ੍ਰਿਪੇਅਰ ਪ੍ਰੈਕਟੀਕਲੀ ਫੋਰ ਦਿਸ ਪਰਟੀਕੁਲਰ ਟੋਪਿਕ। Now you can leave because the other class has to join.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.